How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And if you're looking to get a Czech Republic IP address, this is how you're going to be able to get it, of course, by using a VPN. That is the best option that you're going to get with regards to getting a reliable Czech Republic IP address, especially if you're trying to unblock streaming services from that country. So before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews. I'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So let's start with this page right here that shows that I am in the Netherlands, and that's because, of course, I'm connected to the Netherlands server. Let me go ahead and turn that off, and let me just tell you guys a little bit about these three VPNs so that, of course, they all have Czech Republic servers. Let me just show you, first of all, in the European region. There it is, Czech Republic. Let me just go ahead, actually, and connect and just show you that this works. So when I'm connected, this is wait until I'm connected. Let's go ahead and refresh, continue. And the IP address changed, as you can tell. And the country should show as Czech Republic. Okay, let me just go ahead and just make this smaller. So, you know, with ExpressVPN, so there you go, as you can tell. With ExpressVPN, you're gonna be getting over 3,000 servers in 94 countries. So that is the biggest coverage you're gonna get here amongst all these three VPNs. With NordVPN, let me just go ahead and just turn this off. Now that you guys know Czech Republic is available in every single one of these VPNs, you can tell 1, 2, and 3. ExpressVPN will also allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. And of course, you do get a handful of protocols. I just recommend using lightweight UDP. And of course, you do get the basic security features such as the kill switch here called network lock and split tunneling. If you didn't know, the kill switch will allow you to avoid having any leaks when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. So it will just switch your internet off in case you're in a censorship heavy country. That will prevent any leaks from happening so that your ISP doesn't know what you're doing online. And split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So, you know, you can, for example, route only your torrenting client through the VPN and have the rest of your network untouched by the VPN, if that's something you're interested in, as well as a handful of protocols. I would just recommend using the lightweight UDP protocol. It is the best performing protocol. You can also use automatic. That totally works too, but I prefer using lightweight UDP. So, you know, if maybe the pricing of ExpressVPN is not exactly your cup of tea, you can go with something that's a little bit cheaper, such as NordVPN. Not only that, you'll also get to secure one more device rather than the just 5 devices with ExpressVPN. You'll be able to secure 6 simultaneous devices with NordVPN. You also get specialty servers right here. You get an ad blocker and, of course, the NordLynx protocol, which makes NordVPN the fastest VPN in the business today. Although it's about 3 to 5% faster than ExpressVPN. So yeah, ExpressVPN is still pretty quick. And if you switch to OpenVPN, you'll get access to two more specialty servers, such as dedicated IP and double VPN. Not only do you get the conventional kill switch, but you also get an app kill switch, which will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops. So you'll be able to select which apps will close when your VPN drops or when you turn off the VPN or when your connection drops. Of course, split tunneling, custom DNS if that's something you're interested in, and obfuscated servers in case the regular servers don't work if you're in a censorship heavy country. But if you're in a censorship heavy country, NordVPN will provide you with a special version of NordVPN that looks exactly the same, but it will just let you access the VPN and turn it on without any problems and access all the servers without having to use obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship heavy country. So with Surfshark, of course, if you think maybe NordVPN is still too expensive, well, Surfshark is the ultimate budget VPN, roughly $60 for 2 years. You're still getting the features here, such as multi-hop and static IP. Multi-hop is the same as double VPN, and static IP is the same as dedicated IP here from NordVPN. But if you still want to get an even cheaper VPN, roughly $60 for 2 years of this VPN service, Surfshark is a great VPN. It is the VPN that'll get the job done quite efficiently at the least possible cost. You'll be sacrificing just a little bit of speed and a little bit of security, as well as, you know, some consistency here and there. But still, it is a great VPN for the price you're paying. You still get features, plenty of features such as multi-hop and static IP, which are the same as double VPN and dedicated IP from NordVPN. You're also getting a clean web feature here, which is pretty much the ad blocker, kill switch, whitelister, which is the same as, it's pretty much split tunneling. Of course, you're also getting a handful of protocols. I would definitely recommend sticking to the WireGuard protocol. That is the best protocol. And ShadowSocks protocol will only secure your browser traffic. As you can tell here, it says your non-browser traffic will be exposed. And this is only supposed to be used, by the way, if you're in a censorship-heavy country and you're trying to access banned websites. ShadowSocks protocol will help you reach these banned websites. And if you're in a censorship-heavy country, No Borders Mode will allow you to bypass censorship firewalls, such as the Great Firewall of China, if you're in China. And if you notice, there's no such option in ExpressVPN. That's because the proprietary obfuscation of ExpressVPN lets it work anywhere, no matter your location. It just works just fine without having to toggle anything on and off. And that's part of the premium service offered by ExpressVPN, of course. It works no matter what, with little to no configuration. So that'll be it for this video, guys. Again, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. All these VPNs have a 24/7 live chat support and a 30-day money-back guarantee on all of their plans. So whatever plan you get, you'll be able to get yourself a refund, granted you ask for it before the 30th day. Through the live chat support, you can just ask them for a refund and they'll process you within little to no time. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.